In this video, we're going to be taking a close-up look at the wide range of Barlows that are available to the astronomer, old and new. First of all, let's just take a look at the fundamental basics of a Barlow. What we actually have is a tube, and in that tube, the tube is sized to receive an eyepiece. So at this end, the other end is the same diameter as the eyepiece barrel, and in there is a lens system of some kind. It's usually a negative lens. Sometimes it's one element, sometimes multiple elements. The best ones tend to have two or even three or even four lenses built into them. The idea is quite simple. The Barlow fits in between the eyepiece and the eyepiece holder. So I put the eyepiece into the Barlow, put the Barlow into the telescope, and the Barlow has the effect of doubling the focal length of the telescope. So this telescope has a focal length of 400 millimeters. When I put the Barlow in, it becomes 800 millimeters. Now, when you read up on the internet about Barlows or in books sometimes, you'll tend to see a rather lazy way of talking about Barlows that suggests that the Barlow is actually affecting the eyepiece and simply doubling the magnification. So if it's a 2x Barlow, it doubles the magnification of the eyepiece. So if this is a 10 millimeter eyepiece and we've got a 400 millimeter telescope, this would magnify, divide the 10 millimeters into the 400, we get 40 times. So this eyepiece would deliver 40 times magnification. Insert the Barlow and that immediately becomes 80 times magnification. That's not really what's going on. It's a little bit more subtle than that. The Barlow is actually affecting the primary focal length of the telescope. It's doubling this, not the magnification or focal length of the eyepiece. So the eyepiece isn't suddenly becoming 5 millimeters. It's still 10 mil. It's the Barlow that is actually multiplying the primary focal length of the telescope. It's multiplying this part of the instrument, not this part. Now that's important because it means we can use the Barlow with cameras, for example, and other things that have got nothing to do with eyepieces at all, and it will still have that multiplication effect on the image scale and give us a much bigger, more highly magnified view. So that's quite useful. The other thing that's great about the Barlow is if you have a favorite eyepiece giving you a really nice comfortable view, nice soft eye cup, good eye relief, all that will be preserved when you use the Barlow. So Barlowing an eyepiece is a great way of getting a high power eyepiece out of one of your longer focal length eyepieces. So generally speaking, the Barlow is probably our favourite accessory. If you ask me about one accessory that you need to make sure you have when you've bought a new telescope for the first time, it's going to be a Barlow. And you really won't find any experienced astronomers that haven't got one of two of these in their gadget bag. Now, we're going to start with this one. It's a very basic Barlow. It's actually got a plastic body, and it's okay. It has a single element lens in the front here, and it's okay for with what we would call fun scopes or very basic starter scopes. You wouldn't be able to use this photography because the barrel is made of plastic. You wouldn't want to trust your rather nice camera being attached to this type of Barlow. So we'd recommend that this type of very basic starter Barlow is only used with basic eyepieces. And you will find that going with a Barlow of better quality, better construction and better optics is going to give you better views. So this is an important way to get better performance out of your telescope. So if you've got a telescope that came with a very basic Barlow, think about upgrading that, because you're probably going to get better views if you upgrade the Barlow. Basic Barlows come along in 2x and 3x varieties, but if you move on and just spend a little bit more money, you can get Barlows that have got metal bodies. They've still got fairly basic optics, but a Barlow like this is hovering around the £15 mark. And with a very basic telescope, this is going to improve your views quite considerably. So you haven't got to spend a lot of money to start getting better views. And bear in mind, because it's got a metal body, you could trust this a bit more with your camera. So you could easily put a camera adapter on here and use this with your camera. Quite a wide array of Barlows available in the 15 to 20 to 25 pound bracket. Let's just show you a sort of a slightly more deluxe model Barlow, moving on a little bit to something nice. This Barlow with the black piece on the tip here is actually a removable lens head. Now the great thing about this Barlow, it works at the standard 2x, so by simply putting this into the telescope as it stands, I get the basic 2x magnification out of it. But a really nice trick with this Barlow is by removing the lens head, and screwing that onto the front of the eyepiece, I now get a much more reduced magnification effect of just 1.5 times. And again, the 1.5 times is affecting this telescope. So this is giving me 600 millimeters here rather than the 800 millimeters we were talking about earlier. So it's a more modest increase in magnification. I just want to bring this product to your attention as well. This is an Astro Engineering AC555, a thing called a Magnimax. It doesn't really look anything like a Barlow, but it is by any other name. It's usually called an image amplifier, but you can call all Barlows really image amplifiers. You notice that there's no barrel on here to attach an eyepiece, slide an eyepiece into it. But what you're able to do with this is screw it directly to the filter thread of an eyepiece, pretty much like we were seeing with the Deluxe 1.5 to 2 times Barlow. This just attaches straight to the filter thread. Now, it's also useful, of course, to be able to add this to camera nose pieces. So again, not merely using it with eyepieces, you can screw this straight onto the front of a camera nose piece, add a T-mount to the back of that, and then attach that to your camera. That's actually quite a useful little gimmick, and that's called the AC555 Magnimax from Astro Engineering. Let's put that back in its little box. Let's look at a couple of other photographic Barlows now as well. You can see from these basic designs a very simple refinement. It looks pretty much like an ordinary Barlow. The difference with this one, although we can put eyepieces in here just like all the others, it also has a T-thread built into it around the top there. So that's a standard thread, and that allows us to attach a brand-specific T-mount onto that thread, simply attaching that straight onto there. And hey presto, I can simply line that up and put it on this Canon. And there we go. We're now ready to, I don't think you'd want to put this big camera on this very small telescope, but you can see the idea there now. We've got a means of attaching the camera directly to the telescope. Nice thing about this one in particular, we've got that removable lens head again. So we've got that 2x or 1.5x facility, and we can actually take that off and use it as a basic camera adapter. So by removing that, we've now got a basic prime focus camera adapter there, and very simply put together in that way. This is a very basic, what would be called a photo visual Barlow. There are more sophisticated versions of this. I'm just going to show you those now. One of the best ones that we've come across would be this Astro Engineering AC710. This is probably one of the most sophisticated Barlows of its type. It features Japanese manufactured optics and British made engineering. It looks pretty in its design, and it's got a rather unusual feature. Instead of using these cross screws that tend to push things to one side when you attach them together, this one actually has a clamping ring. So once I take the cap out, you can see there's no cross screw on it, and it actually uses this rather nice collet to actually secure the eyepiece. So when I put the eyepiece in here, I simply undo it and then tighten it up, and it holds the eyepiece, centering it automatically as I actually do it up. But the really nice thing about the AC710 is if we take that all the way off, it reveals underneath a T-thread. So once again, we can attach that directly to the front of our camera. Now, these so-called Supreme Barlows is the name of this product. This is the AC710. It's actually available in a number of octane grades. So this one is 2x and 1.5x. And one of the big ones at the back here, this is a 5x Barlow. Now, you wouldn't normally use this kind of Barlow simply with a large SLR like this. The 5x fits exactly the same as the 2x and 1.5x model. These high-powered Barlows in 4x and 5x tend to be the preserve of much smaller chipped cameras, where you really want to get the image scale up to be able to photograph planets and that kind of thing. These very, very small cameras, like a webcam or some of the CCTV surveillance cameras that are increasingly used for astrophotography, have relatively small chips, and you really do need to get the focal ratio of the telescope up dramatically to get a high impact image onto these very small chip cameras. So it works exactly the same as the 2x Barlows. Obviously the camera goes into the 5x Barlow and then into the scope. This time that 5x multiplication is going to have a massive effect on the focal length of the telescope. What started as 400 millimeters is obviously going to be 2000 millimeters after we've multiplied it by the 5x. So bear in mind, an important caveat here is you need to bear in mind that when you're using these very high power Barlows, any tiny little touch of the telescope that you're using it with is also going to be magnified 5x. So bear in mind that there's always kind of a downside with a Barlow. The more you ladle on the power, the more you're going to be troubled by vibration and centering the target on the chip. It's a good idea to do these kind of things modestly, just enough to win, basically. So that's just one little word of warning that you need when using these very high power Barlows. Worth bearing in mind too that Barlows don't only come in inch and a quarter size, they're increasingly available now as in 2-inch furniture size. Now there's a lot to be said for using 2-inch furniture, especially when you're using cameras. It's all that much more substantial and it feels a little bit safer using 2-inch furniture on your telescope. But it's worthwhile bearing in mind that the volume production is still an inch and a quarter, and you do tend to get significantly better value for money and performance. Be quietly suspicious of relatively cheap 2-inch Barlows. You know, bear in mind the size of the optics and everything else that you're getting. Cheap 2-inch Barlows sometimes are inferior to mid-priced inch and a quarter Barlows. So that's just a small observation about the state of the market actually right now. Let's just summarise what we've been talking about very quickly. We noted that the basic Barlows you tend to get with a starter scope are often very basic and well worthwhile upgrading with something just a little bit better to give you slightly better views. Wide range available in that group there, 2x and 3x Barlows. Be mindful that as you increase the magnification, you're going to increase other issues like the difficulty of keeping the scope steady and that kind of thing. So restrict yourself to the 2x where possible. We slid then into the better quality Barlows offering the 1.5 and 2x magnification, a far more versatile instrument giving you a wider range of magnifications. Bear in mind that one of these Barlows turns every eyepiece you've got into three magnifications. So you've got the eyepiece on its own, the eyepiece at 2x, and the eyepiece at 1.5x. So this is a very useful way of expanding your eyepiece collection. We then naturally moved on to the idea of using Barlows with your photographic equipment, and we highlighted the value of Barlows that have actually got a T-thread built into them to allow us to put a T-adapter so that we can put our camera straight onto it. We then showed you the more sophisticated type of photovisual Barlow, like the Astro Engineering AC710 here, that has that rather nice centering eyepiece lock and the T-thread underneath its hat. We then looked at the big guns, these very, very powerful photo imaging Barlows offering 4x and 5x in the examples that we had here. Bear in mind that these Barlows in particular are significantly less versatile than the model we looked at earlier on, because they're really ideally designed for use with relatively small chip cameras to be able to get relatively small targets like planets and perhaps individual craters on the moon to fill the chip on these kind of very popular cameras now, these webcams and CCTV imaging cameras. And we also noted in passing, of course, that 2x Barlows are available in the 2-inch standard 2-inch fitting size. Gives you quite a bit to think about there, quite a wide range of products to select from. Okay, hope that helps. Bye for now.